not just for this weekend, but for the whole year.
Thank you. 先生们，各位老师，各位家长，各位同学，大家上午好。非常高兴今天受邀来参加汉基杭州中心的十年级的结业式。时光荏苒，很快同学们在这里就度过了一年的学习时光。回想当初的决定，从我们今天的成果来看，回想我们就感觉到，就像刚才许先生所说的那样，当初的这个决定，杭州市政府的这个决定，乃至于我们绿城集团的决定是非常的正确的。由于你们的到来，使得我们能够有机会近距离的观察、学习、借鉴香港汉基的先进的教育理念和教育教学的管理方式。也是因为有你们的到来，使得我们绿城育华学校的孩子们有了一个跟大家一起互动、相互学习、相互促进的机会。也是因为有你们的到来，使得我们与香港汉基教育中心，使我们杭州与香港都拉近了时空的距离。今天各位同学付出了辛勤的努力，出色地完成了学业。我预祝同学们在今后的学习和人生的道路上越走越好，也衷心的期望使各位同学在这里度过的一年时光给大家留下最美好的回忆。大家在这里学习生活，我们作为绿城教育集团有着义不容辞的责任为大家服务好。由于我们的经验缺乏，由于我们的设施有限和能力有限，可能还有诸多不尽人意的地方，至此也请大家多多包涵。最后祝大家身体健康，生活愉快，谢谢大家。
Today to speak about my experiences at CIS Hangzhou. I'll be speaking on behalf of the second floor girls, as many of them wanted to be up here today, and I feel fortunate to be the one to represent my floor. After I heard about their program last year, I felt like it would be a really great experience and something I would regret if I passed it up. Although my decision was late and spontaneous, I definitely think I made the right choice. Spending a year in a country halfway across the world from your hometown is kind of terrifying, but for some reason, I knew this year would be memorable. Not only did I meet probably a few of the most interesting people, but this year allowed me to experience a lot more than what was in my comfort zone. This whole year was all about challenging myself in ways I thought I could. From coaching kids soccer, bargaining with street vendors in Chinese, to hiking in the heat, and interacting with locals. Just from stepping outside my comfort zone, I learned a lot more this year than I ever could back in New York. Not only did I push myself, but also this year helped me identify myself as someone of Chinese heritage. I know this is a bit cliche, but it was something I hadn't done yet. 明年我爸爸妈妈会遵循中国传统习俗过中国的节日，但是我不太明白，为什么他们一定要遵循这些事？虽然他们是中国人，我们住在美国，所以我希望我们能一起遵循美国的传统习俗。通过在杭州这一年，我懂得中国传统习俗的意思，为什么遵循这些事很重要对我的家庭。我也觉得我对自己的文化获得了一个更深的了解。And on behalf of Jazz Top, she would like to say, this year I learned more about others, about appreciating our surroundings, but I've also learned a lot more about myself and understanding what's important to me and what isn't. Understanding what is important and what isn't this year has helped me overcome stress issues and any other problems I've faced in the past. And learning about myself has allowed me to no longer neglect flaws or issues that I've faced in the past, but to embrace the future, and all this has happened because of CIS Hangzhou. I would like to thank my teachers, my friends, and the people who helped bring the school up, because without you, I would have been a girl who didn't truly understand the potential she had. And on behalf of Kamika Herbst, she would like to say, during my stay in Hangzhou, I got to know CIS Hangzhou community a lot more. While I got to know individual people a lot better, I was able to understand what kind of community we were as a whole. And I discovered what my role was in it, and where I fit in CIS Hong Kong. I was able to distance myself from my peers as if I wanted to, but here I couldn't. Because I'm generally not a very social person, living and working with the close community 24/7 meant that I had to change a little. I became more outgoing, confident, and more able to make friends, and I now as though feel I have more potent role in not only the CIS Hangzhou community, but also the wider CIS community. I would also like to take this time to thank Mr. Pratt, the leadership team, teaching staff, coach mentors, and most of all, the students who took the bold step in participating and successfully complete the first year of CIS Hangzhou. Without you all, this year would have not come together so perfectly. Thank you.
Thanks, Andy, for that amazing speech. It's true that everyone has their own growing up experience in Hangzhou, and it's certain that we've all developed in different ways throughout this year. 我们个人的成长经历都很不同，但我们都从杭州的得到的收获都很大。那邀请我们下一个宾客，不是宾客，我们的一个学生 Charlie Salnico, the charming, amazing, athletic, lots of other great adjectives here, to come up on the stage and tell us about his experience.
Of summing up my experiences here in about 2 minutes. My favorite memory of this year would be sitting on top of a roof about 2 hours away from here in a town where we just finished teaching some kids some football. It was a rugby sevens weekend and the sun was setting and I had some lemon tea in my hand. And the one thought which crossed my mind as this town was slowly ending for the day was, there's nowhere I'd rather be but here. And that thought has been on my mind all year long. There's nowhere I'd rather be but CIS Hangzhou. We did not come here because we thought it would be easy. We came here because we expected it to be hard. We wanted to be challenged and we wanted to be tested. But when I look into the eyes of the students in front of me, I see a sense of fulfillment, a sense of adventure, and most of all, a sense of expedition. And yes, there have been times of great difficulty, but you'd be crazy to think that there wasn't going to be. But we've emerged not just bigger, but stronger. Stronger in ways we've never been before. And we've learned not to let our problems define us, but to learn from them. As the second floor boys, we've come from surviving the treacherous mountains of Mogashan to revising for a semester exam. We've been a team, and we've shared the funnest of times and the greatest of experiences. We've been diligent students, and we've worked hard all year long. But when you reduce us to a bunch of guys who will play poker for a slice of pizza, we're the best of friends. And this goes for all the students here. The sense of community and the sense of friendship has defined this year into one which we will never forget. We are the inaugural class of CIS Hangzhou, and we've started something which is bigger than anyone here can ever imagine. Because we are truly fantastic people, we have learned that there's no reward without risk. For us, our time in Hangzhou is coming to an end, but for many, this is just the beginning of something which will change the lives of hundreds in the future. Soon we'll be leaving our beloved classrooms, dormitories, lunch lines, and that have heard our joy throughout the year, and will forever echo through the halls. But of course, this would not have happened if it wasn't for the amazing people who've helped shape us into the individuals we are today. Thank you, Mr. Pratt, and the leadership team, the teachers who have had to deal with us every day, the coach mentors who have become some of our closest friends, and most of all, the students who have come with us all together on this journey. So I leave you with this Chinese quote. 学习是永远跟随主人的把握. Learning is a treasure that will follow its owner everywhere. And finally, I'd like to give this present on behalf of everyone to Mr. Pratt. It's a photo book with all of us in it. So Mr. Pratt, you'd like to come out. Thank you.
Thanks, Charlie, for that really thoughtful speech. Now, 我们下一个来演讲的人就是我们的一个家长. He's tall. He's definitely really persuasive. We have Guy Chambers.
What an introduction. I don't quite know how to follow that. Good morning, everybody. I've been asked on behalf of the four parent representatives to say a few words on behalf of the parents of the children here at CIS Hangzhou. And as so much has been said over the weeks and the months, that in some respect it could be quite difficult to sum it up here in a few minutes. But on reflection, it's actually pretty simple. There's probably only four words that hold up on our hearts which want to express today. So on behalf of the parents, to the staff and the teachers, the coach mentors, the whole faculty here, and especially to Rich and to Jeong, you took a brave decision to commit your lives and careers to a new and uncertain challenge called CIS Hangzhou. We simply say thank you. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts. You've provided guidance, inspiration, and care to our children in more ways than any of us parents could do ourselves. And to our children, who took the brave decision to leave the comfort of their home back in Hong Kong and in different parts of the world, and to leave their friends on the Brainerd Hill campus, to be the first cohort of students coming here to Hangzhou and embark on a totally new and unfamiliar environment. We say, well done. We are incredibly proud of you and what you've become as a year. You've all taken a decision to take the road less traveled. The road was unknown, it was unclear, and uncertain. Success was never guaranteed. But all progress in life stems from taking steps into the unknown and moving towards a more certain goal. What you've achieved today is a degree of self-confidence, self-reliance, and independence that no teaching in a classroom could do. This will be an invaluable experience for each of you to take with you for the rest of your lives. In the next few days, you'll be leaving here. You'll be leaving here, the campus of Hangzhou. But this pioneering spirit of the first year of Hangzhou campus will remain with you inside your hearts and your minds forever. Use it wisely. Continue to build yourselves. Go into the world and make a difference. So, thank you.
Chinese channel.
我们表示你的非常热烈的祝贺。 There's probably just a couple of words in Chinese which I'll just leave there. Sanra is Xin, the old Shi. Shifu Ling Jin, Xiu Qin Zako. The three people are walking together. Always one of them can be my teacher. But teachers open doors. But development depends on you.
Thank you, Mr. Chambers, for that heartfelt speech. Your speech perfectly represents what CIS Hangzhou is supposed to represent. Bilingualism, confidence, and an aura of greatness that we all want to have at some point in our lives. Now, the next two speakers that we have are coach mentors. I'm sure if you ask any of the students here, they will have their own unique experiences, let's leave it at that, with their own coach mentors. For now, I'd like to invite the wonderful, insightful, and third floor's very best, Yohei, to give a speech.
In the学习过程中，我们从我们的住宿老师学到很多。现在请我的自己的住宿老师给他的演讲，谢谢。
I'm representing the coach mentors, but I didn't really get their input because I was writing the speech at a time when nobody else was awake. 这一年是一段很奇妙的人生旅程。虽然我回到这个熟悉的环境，但是不再是一个学生的角色，而是他们的榜样。 While CIS was and still is dear to me, as a fresh university graduate, I had certain anxieties coming back because I was taking on a role that I wasn't even sure I could fulfill. I kept asking myself, how could Mr. Pratt trust somebody who is not even legal to drink in the US to take care of these students? Moreover, the fact that I was missing a shower head and that the building wasn't properly built definitely did not help me settle into the challenges that were lying ahead. But like every meaningful journey, we have all came a long way, and in the process have learned invaluable lessons. 但是我今天并不是想讲一年所遇到的困难和处理方法。我想讲一下对我来说是一个很重要的习惯。I think we have all heard this question way too often. How is Hangzhou? 或者是杭州怎么样? Expect to hear more of it when you go back to Hong Kong. 可是我每次被问到这个问题的时候，我无法好好的回答。 I don't know if it is because I have a poor memory, or my inability to put such meaningful experiences in words. But when people ask me about my experiences in CIS or LSC, I feel like the response I'm giving does not do justice to what I went through. If you ever feel that way, I just want to remind you that it is okay. Also, if you ever felt like you didn't appreciate every moment enough, I also want to tell you that it is just being human and it is okay too. To me, it is about enriching your identity by embodying the meaningful experiences that you went through. 为了提高完善自己，你必须要用每一段的经历来充实你的人生旅程。From CIS, I have taken our two graduation quotes to heart. The first by Dr. Seuss: "Don't cry because it is over; smile because it happened." Has continued to help me positively move on from every experience and also overcome the sorrows of parting ways. The second, 经历是长一智, which roughly translates to becoming more wise with every experience, has inspired me to take on different challenges in the hopes of enriching myself. 从大学，我就学到用一个国际关系的角度来分析我周围的事情。 And after Hangzhou, I intend to give everybody a chance to speak and listen carefully. Because if there's anything I've learned this year, it is that there's definitely something to take away from all of you. 这一年，我们经常会听到 听得到我们生活辅导员对学生的影响有多么好，但是我们从他们身上也学到了很多东西。 from you guys, I've learned way too many inappropriate things for my liking. The struggles of being short, how childish I am, the various symptoms of different STIs, and how bubbly my butt is. But in all seriousness, I have been reminded of the importance of listening. Even as the younger ones, you have very insightful things to say sometimes. 这就是我想给老师和家长们的一个提示。只要你有耐心，花一点时间听一下你们孩子要说的话，你肯定会学到一些有意思的知识或者是意见。 And sometimes, I do stress sometimes, you will be pleasantly surprised by what they have to say. So before I close, I wanted to pose this question to you. What are you going to embody from your experience in Hangzhou? Whether it is responding everything and anything with
what the
becoming a change maker, crazily dancing to Steve Aoki's remix of Pursuit of Happiness, or realizing and appreciating your parents' unconditional love and support, despite being 679 miles away from you. What is it that you're going to take away and truly embody?
你从这一年会选哪方面的经历来充实你未来的旅程呢?
No outsiders will truly understand the experience you went through. But by actively embodying an aspect of your experience, I believe it is one of the more powerful ways to help yourself and help others understand your journey in Hangzhou. To close, I just wanted to express my gratitude for such a memorable experience to all of you, faculty, staff, parents, and finally to the 58 pioneers. Be good to each other, and congratulations once again.
Thank you, Yohei, for that interesting speech. Now, Yohei 说的特别对，我们在人生道路上肯定会遇到很多挑战和灾难，但不管我们遇到什么，我们一定要坚持努力，克服困难，不断的发展和提高自己的能力，相信自己。那我们下一个来演讲的人就是也是一个住宿老师。 I would like to invite the amazing, enigmatic, and definitely very cute coach mentor, Nat Lau, to the stage.
If you knew me, you would know that one of my major anxieties is traveling. I'm the person who needs to get to the airport 3 hours early just to be safe, or has a death grip on my Chrome browser opened up to Baidu Ditu while I'm taking the bus. I have a penchant for getting lost. It's a talent, really. Yet, somehow, many of my favorite memories in Hangzhou have taken place on some form of transportation. Getting to know Hannah and Gabby on a K25 bus. My nice heart-to-heart chat with Charlie on the way back from our PEID. Discussing future investment plans with Andy and Charlotte on our 2-hour-long bus ride to grassroots football. My weekly excursions with Crystal to her dance class, and who could forget taking a sketchy Sanlin to with 80 after an hour-long impossible battle of trying to catch a cab in the city of Hangzhou. The truth is, in most of these instances, I don't even remember where I was going or where I was coming from, because the truth is, that didn't matter. In the words of Ralph Waldo Emerson, life is a journey, not a destination. 人生是一个旅程,而不是终点. This year's journey has been so much more than surviving year 10, or finishing a year's contract, or setting up an excellent academic institution. It's about everything we've learned along the way. I know I'm the coach mentor, and it is literally my job to teach the kids how to live life, but let's be real. Most of the time, these teenagers are way smarter than I am. So today, I'd like to share a list of life lessons that I've learned from the CIS Hangzhou class of 2014. I would like to share with you the ways in which the students have coached and mentored me.
这是我这年从汉基杭州的学生得到的生活教训。 1. That it is indeed physically possible to stay on top of rigorous academics, be incredibly involved with extracurricular projects, get 8 hours of sleep a night, and stay on top of 30 different TV shows. Though I wouldn't recommend it. Saying, what the, and what? As an appropriate response to all of life's most difficult questions. That you can diffuse almost any situation by saying, JK, I love you, and don't worry about it, you're beautiful. That STDs look disgusting, and that I should do whatever it takes not to get any. That a day is just better spent if you whistle through the entire thing. Marcus and John, I'm looking at you. That going the extra mile for that $2 shouting is always worth it. That you can achieve almost any crazy sounding idea if you just persist by pushing your teachers and coach mentors to the brink of insanity. To have a good sense of humor about the bad things that happen. To feel passionately.
对事要有乐观的看法。 对生活要有好奇心。
To think independently, critically, and creatively, not being afraid to question why things are the way they are. To be honest, sometimes painfully honest to myself and to others. To sometimes forgo practicality and to chase after the things I love. That the things worth having, like great friendships, take time and a lot of hard work to build. That the half an hour day spent with family can make all the difference.
对别人要向心向爱，照顾大家。
That regardless of how different two people are or how much two personalities clash, that we can set our differences aside and not just get along, but learn to love one another. And finally, how to be good friends. Outside of any official classroom, I am still constantly learning and often learning from seemingly unexpected sources. It's the little things, the side comments, the spontaneous moments, the walks off the beaten path that have really shaped this year for me. Dear class of 2014, if there is one thing we as a faculty try to show you this year, it's that learning happens everywhere. It may happen in an offhand conversation with the Ba'an, or teaching little kids how to play soccer, or even in a giant mud fight. Don't discount things that aren't purely academic as a waste, because they only become a waste when you fail to see the lesson. Yes, our year in Hangzhou has come to an end, and we have successfully reached our intended destination, but the journey is far from over. I pray that you don't compartmentalize this year or box away the lessons we've learned, because this is merely a single step in the process of our learning. Like Yohei, I also hope that we can embody the things we've learned in Hangzhou and continue to nurture them as we take them forward and make our way to the next destination. I know that the next chapter feels uncertain. It may even feel daunting. But I beg you, please don't spend the entire journey fixated on the blue dot on your phone as it moves along by Du Ditu. Look up and keep learning. Talk to that lady sitting next to you on the bus. Observe how demographics change as you go along your bike ride. Draw a picture based on the fluid dynamics of the airplane you're sitting on. The opportunities are endless. Finally, I want to say thank you. Thank you, Mr. Pratt, my faithful colleagues, parents, and students, for making this year what it was and for the invaluable lessons you have taught me to and to each other. Ilu Pinan.
Without a doubt, the coach mentors, all eight of them, they shaped and helped us become what we have become this year. I was talking to a really good friend of mine yesterday, and he said that the end is perhaps the most beautiful thing in the world because it's the beginning of something new. So thanks, Nat and Yohei, for those heartfelt speeches. Now, I know that everyone who attended this closing ceremony wants to hear more about the students, and therefore we will limit it.
是这一年一起活动、一起交友、一起成长、一起享受我们青春美好的时光。我们下一个来演讲的人就是我们的一个学生，我们漂亮又聪明的 Maddie Wei。
大家好，我从小就在香港，跟我三个姐姐 Alexandra、 Zoe 和 Victoria 一样。我们都上韩籍国际学校，我的姐姐们以前从来没有嫉妒过我，除了这次，他们听到我有机会来到杭州一年。现在看来，他们的机会是对的。 因为一年真这一年真的是我最难忘的一年。这个机会真的是一生一次的机会，我真的很幸运。在这一年，我不但认识了很多新的同学们，也交了很多新的朋友 ，both with students from CIS and from Greentown University. This year has given me endless opportunities to improve my Chinese, and I took complete advantage of that. Over the course of this year, my Chinese has progressively improved, and that's the main reason why I decided to come here in the first place. Those who know me should know that I adore food, so it should come as no surprise when I say that the best bonding experiences that I had with the girls on the third floor were during birthday parties or Christmas parties, or when Zhang Laoshi was feeling especially kind and made us tang yuan, which we lined up bowls in hand for in her apartment. Having grown up in a household with three sisters, adjusting to the dorm life was not hard for me. I was looking forward to it from the start, not knowing that the third floor girls and I would become so close over the course of this year. Moving back into our old homes won't be easy. I will miss the shrieks of girls when they discover that the toilet has been clogged. I will miss the Sunday morning dumpling runs to the sketchy dumpling shop across the street. I will miss the gleeful shrieks that we all let out after having zapped to death a mosquito using the electric mosquito killer. And most of all, I will miss the nighttime chats that I had with the girls in my dorm. Jemima, Hannah, and Vanessa. After a long, tiring, assessment-filled yet fun year, I must say that I am truly glad that I made the decision a year ago to come to CIS Hangzhou. 我真的很高兴我在一年前做了决定来到韩籍杭州。 I would like to say one thing to all of those people that created this wonderful experience for me. Thank you.
Speeches today, I think it's safe to say that there's a recurring theme that everyone is happy that CIS Hangzhou had an opportunity to blossom and to happen. Just moving on from that. So originally I was supposed to give a speech, but when I figured out I should to be the master of ceremonies today, I had no other better person to ask to give a speech of his thoughts than John Yap, a good friend of mine on the third floor. 现在请我的好朋友叶耀文上来给他的演讲，谢谢。This works. It's ironic. Many a time, we appreciate nostalgia and memories more than the actual events themselves as they unfold. However, let's be real. The memory of CIS Hangzhou and any emotional attachment we have to it right now will sooner or later fade away. 我不是说这一年没有意思, 而是说，不管我们多么喜欢汉西杭州，我们离开这里以后，生活还是要继续。 Next year, when we are freaking out about getting our PPs in on time, the year after that, when we are stressing over mocks and SATs, the year after that, when we are gearing up and prepping and applying for college, CIS Hangzhou will just be a faint memory, unfortunately. 那我们怎么办呢? 一个办法就是收藏各种各样的纪念品，例如照片和年鉴等等。 来确定我们永远会记得这一年。虽然这些都是好的，我觉得更加重要是现在花时间来回忆这一年，因为纪念是一个那一瞬间的东西。于是，我想对我的朋友们说，谢谢你们陪伴了我一整年，给了这一年它的意义。我想跟我的老师们说， 谢谢你们总是支持我、领导我和忍耐我。Furthermore, I'm sure the entire third floor is saying this with me when I say, thank you, Mr. Wei. Throughout the year, we may have paid you that gratitude in the form of bad debts, headaches, heartaches, stubbornness, and other forms of worthless currencies. But now, as the year draws to an end, you deserve nothing but the universally tradable currency. Thank you. In good times and bad times. In good times, in bad times, in times of good food and in times of not so good food, you have literally always been there. But more than thanking everyone for making an impact to my life this year, I want to address my floor, my house, third floor, and say, you know, we did well this year. More than academics, more than Chinese language, more than, you know, sports and more than hobbies, we as a group have grown incredibly tight, incredibly trusting, and it now makes me incredibly sad that some of the friends I spent this smashing year with may not be returning back to CIS Hong Kong or Hong Kong at all. Next year, there will be no more intensive gossiping sessions in Mr. Wei's living room. There will be no more hide and seek with Chen Yuan. There will be no more durian birthday cake shared with Richie. There will be no more Axel-led cotillions. There will be no more Saturday Papa John's pizza nights in dorms, and thank God, there will be no more musical whistling. Well, at least less. There will be no more revolutionary breakfast songs by Finn. There will be no more rowdy nights in Richie's room. There will be no more Chinatown or Tongyangai. Our time spent in CIS Hangzhou will soon be no more. At this point, I think I ought to suck it up. I'm going to be with most of you next year anyways, so why does my speech sound like a eulogy? As this year comes to an end, in a way, it's somewhat like death. We are transitioning to a new, relatively unknown state and environment, and like that, that state might be heaven, or frankly put, year 11 might be hell. But guess what? We're all in the same boat together. And so now we look forward. Good luck to us all.
While a lot of things that John shared in his speech might sound comical and ridiculous, they are ironically what made this year most memorable. And I'm sure that all students can agree with that. Now, the next set of speakers that I'd like to introduce are both teachers. Without the teachers, they living alongside us and teaching us at the same time, I'm sure that our educational experience wouldn't have been as powerful. The next speaker, just by looking at him, he's not fit for the classroom in both appearance and height. I guess they're the same thing.
Next, I'd like to invite Mr. Kinzer, our geography teacher, to the stage. 现在请我的有奇怪又有趣的地理老师来给我们演讲。Mr. Kinzer, I didn't trash talk you, don't worry.
This always happens. Thanks, Kenny, for that introduction. It's a pleasure to be up here today to represent the teachers, but I do want to issue a disclaimer. The way I was chosen to represent the teachers was, I happened not to be in the faculty meeting where they decided to meet. So please forgive me. I also, having been nominated, we'll call it a nomination, to share with you today, it was hard for me to figure out how best to represent my colleagues and how best to speak to the students. So I decided to try to just come up with one word that represented that experience, and it actually resonates with so much of what's already been said today, including the very end of John's speech, which is hard to follow. I don't have nearly as many good jokes or inside jokes for all of you to laugh at, I apologize. John mentioned that we're all in this together, and it occurs to me now that I probably could have incorporated some Chinese into my speech just by learning the word together. So I'm sorry, I should have done that, note to self. But we're all in this together, and together is the word that I chose. Together has some warm and fuzzy connotations, like maybe the rowdy nights in Richie's room. It has, you know, when we think of doing something together, we want to embrace, right? We want to be happy. But togetherness, as most of us have probably learned, and I think the students and my colleagues have learned this year, togetherness is not always so pretty. It's not always so warm and fuzzy. In fact, it's often really, really hard. It can be difficult. And we can finish this year in eulogies, sort of memorializing this year with smiles in our faces and warm feelings in our hearts, but I think the thing that resonates most with me is the struggle, the challenge. For me, embracing an incredibly diverse set of colleagues as we try to figure out how to work together to best support the students here. Equally diverse student body with so many different interests. How do we create a space for them to really flourish, to really show their true potential? Together is really hard. It's been a really big challenge. But it's also the only hope that we have. And as we do part away, some of you, yes, are going back to return to CIS Hangzhou. And you will continue to be together in physical space. You'll see each other every day. And yeah, maybe the memory of CIS Hangzhou might begin to fade. It probably will. But the fact that you did it together, that you learned how to do things together, not just in the classroom, not just on projects, that's probably one of the least meaningful ways that you learn to do things together here, but the way that you learn to live together. Mr. Pratt shared a word, as we talk a lot about developing independence, he shared sort of a reframe on that idea of independence with the word interdependence. And I think you guys have achieved that. So whether you're going back to Boston or New York or Manila, anywhere else in the world, you're going back to Hong Kong, go together. Do it together.
Really touching speech, teared up a little bit on the inside. But for all the Chinese people out there who might not have understood like exactly what he said, Mr. K 在讲的就是我们这一年在一起的收获很大，就是我们不仅是个人的成长、个人的发现很值得，但是我们一起克服困难、一起挑战自己的过程，才是最值得。 那我们下一个演讲的人就是我们很独特的一个数学老师。 I would like to invite Mrs. Pratt on the board.
Molly, I just want to say I was also volunteered by my colleagues when I was waiting for the staff meeting. And every speaker has been fantastic, so it does make me feel quite nervous. So, okay. 各位领导、各位来宾、各位家长、各位同学、各位小朋友，大家上午好。我叫建平，我是汉字杭州的一位数据老师。我今天很荣幸，也很激动，能够站在这里和大家分享一下我这一年以来在汉字杭州工作和生活的收获点滴。我的名字是有一点奇怪。 但是我的的确确是土生土长的中国人，94年我去了英国，在英伦半岛上生活了18个春秋，英国队加油！去年的夏天，我和先生一起来到了你们美丽而又热情的西子湖畔，我们俩成为了汉字杭州的两份子。 这一年下来，我才真正的感觉到了什么叫做活到老要学到老。在教学中，我和孩子们一起进步了；在生活中，我和大伙儿一起相处了。这几百天中发生了很多小故事，让我很难忘，有很多点滴让我很感动。我在这里就想对我们汉基杭州的先锋们说一声谢谢，你们，因为你们真的是很棒。希望你们回到汉基杭州，汉基香港，对不起。
Sorry for the logistics. Getting 57 students on a tiny little city is really difficult. Now, just seeing from both of those speeches, they were both a result of not going to regularly scheduled commitments. Looking at the quality of those speeches, perhaps it's a reminder that students should stop going to some of their commitments. No, I'm just kidding, not really. So now I'd like to invite the CIS Hangzhou student body to sing a couple of songs that sort of commemorate our experience. 现在我想请我们的汉基杭州学校的合唱队来唱歌，谢谢。
And before we start the song, we'd like to just introduce the song. The song was written by one of the students, a group of students on the project week, and the conductor of the song is one of the composers of the song.
在我们合唱开始之前，希望给大家介绍一下这首歌。这是我们汉基杭州的学生一个学生团队在项目周的时候自己编写的歌曲，而这首歌的指挥，也就是这首歌的核心编曲者之一，Kelly。 Closer. I guess I sort of understood what it meant finally. What it's trying to say is that the people who play football, they are the very physical embodiment of the spirit of football. The sportsmanship, the manners, the skills, the athleticism that's involved. And then just like that, all of us here, the parents, the teachers, the faculty, and even the students themselves, they are the very physical embodiment of what CIS Hangzhou is, the spirit of what we are. And I'm sure that people can take many things away from you, what you own, what you are, but they can't take away that spirit away from you. So I want you to go on after today and continue to share that spirit within everyone you see. Thank you.
I don't think I can top Kenny's remarks, especially if I'm speaking Chinese, but I'll do my best. So, 特别感谢今天所有家长、学生、贵宾来我们这个典礼。我们这一年在杭州真的是一个意外的经历，也特别感谢所有让我们有这个机会的人。我们以后未来会继续努力，然后发展自己。 我们把我们所有在杭州学到的知识，所有我们学到的新的，好像个人发展的知识来，在我们自己生活里尽量继续努力进步。好，那我们典礼就是到这儿为结束，谢谢大家。 我们也特别很荣幸，真的当你们今天的好像 MC， 谢谢你们。